Most people are probably familiar with the amount of CO2 that humans are putting into the atmosphere and the associated global warming that's occurring with that. But less known is that some of that CO2, about a third of it, is actually being absorbed in the oceans, and that's causing the oceans to acidify. Now, quite a lot of research has been done on how ocean acidification will affect the growth of corals, but little is known about the sediments that make up the majority of these reefs. And these sediments are really important for the formation of the reefs and coral lagoons, and in the aerial extent of reefs, they could be about 95% of the reefs. So they're a really important component of reefs. These sediments are formed from the breakdown of corals and other carbonate-producing organisms. So our research looked into the effects of ocean acidification on these carbonate sediments. And what we found was that in about 30 years, on average, most of these sediments will start dissolving, which means that we will no longer have these sediments accumulating on reefs and being available for the building of coral reefs. We travelled to four reefs around the globe in two ocean basins, Heron Island here in Australia, Tetiaroa, French Polynesia, Hawaii and Bermuda. And at each of those locations we did the same set of experiments where we took benthic chambers which we put on the sediment surface, on the surface of these carbonate sands on the reefs, and then we acidified these chambers to represent future ocean acidification. So by what we expect the ocean will look like with respect to acidity by the end of the century. And then we looked at how those sands responded. And what we found was that when we acidified those chambers, those sands dissolved much more rapidly. But what was really interesting is each of those reefs did respond differently. So for example, Hawaii was already net dissolving. So already the sediments there have already started to dissolve. And that's because that system is under anthropogenic stress. It's already got a lot of nutrient and organic matter loading happening. Whereas we go to a system like Tetiaroa in the French Polynesia, that's a very pristine system, and it was hardly net dissolving even by the end of the century. So different reefs will respond differently. So what we need to do is put pressure on governments globally to work in concert to basically reduce CO2 emissions. This is the only way in which we can reduce or slow down ocean acidification. And if we don't do that, sediments will start dissolving within the next 30 years.